गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 5, वेलकम टू योर ऑनलाइन साइंस क्लास। वी आर टुडे स्टार्टिंग विद अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज बोन्स एंड मसल्स ऑफ यूनिट 2, सेकंड चैप्टर। इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी हैव डन सॉइल इरोशन एंड कंजर्वेशन। वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ सॉइल एंड हाउ सॉइल इज हेल्पिंग अस टू लिव एंड ग्रो, इजंट इट, एंड फाइनली व्हाई दे आर वेस्टिंग एंड व्हाट आर द way of conservation. Today we are going to learn about different bones and muscles, different body parts and different organs and organic system of our body, which are helping us to do our work, which is helping us to survive. And different types of muscles are there, different types of bones are there, and between these bones different types of joints are there, which are helping us to do various types of functions in our day-to-day life. So please go to page number 51. Our body consists of several organs. Each organ has a job to do. So each functions, each organs are doing different job or different functions. For example, the lungs absorb oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. The heart pumps blood to different parts of the body. The stomach helps to digest the food. Now see why these different examples are given, because these are different organs which are doing different functions. Like lungs is helping us to absorb oxygen and give out carbon dioxide, the process we know. And when we are releasing the carbon dioxide, it is being taken by the plants during daytime, and they used to prepare their food in the process of photosynthesis, and they are again giving rise to oxygen, which are very important for us. Now the heart pumps the blood to different part of our body. So heart is continuously pumping like that. It is squeezing and again coming back to its own place. Again squeezing and again coming back to its original place. Now this is helping the blood to circulate in our body. And the stomach is helping to digest the food. Now the organs are doing their work, all right. But in the next part of the chapter we will see that these organs are not doing work separately. They are joined together, and the organs which are connecting together forming different organic system. That we will read in the next phase. The organs in the body do not work alone. They work together with other organs. Several organs working together perform one major functions for the body. So the meaning of this is that all these are different organs in our body, and they are quietly linked with each other and they are functioning together. Like what easy example I can give, suppose class 5 is a body, and each of the students including me is an organ, separate organs. But when the teacher is teaching you, you are learning separately. But when you are giving the exam at that time, or when you are in an project work, suppose when you are doing it in a group, you all form a group. Suppose in Saraswati Puja, when you make project, you together join together and you make a successful project, isn't it? At that time you becomes a unit one. So why I am giving this example, because that will help you to understand that though the organs are working separately, like you people are studying in your home separately, but when you are doing something, when you are activated, when you are doing something, some work, you are forming group and you are joining together to make one project successful. Like that, different organs are joining together to perform a task. Like, see the examples are given. Several organs working together to perform one major function for the body. For example, the stomach alone cannot digest the food. The stomach is helping to digest the food, but it will not function alone. Other organs such as teeth, salivary gland, food pipe, small intestine, large intestine, liver, pancreas and some other work together with the stomach to digest the food you eat and through the waste. So, see, teeth, salivary gland is different types of gland which are over here it is situated, and they used to secrete when we take food. Saliva is coming in our mouth, and the salivary gland is secreting the hormone called saliva, and it is helping the food to digest, and through the food pipe it is going inside, and small intestine is helping to digest the food, to digest, and a large intestine is helping to release the waste material from our body as well as pancreas, and some other work together to make eat our food. We are eating not only stomach functioning, we are eating the food, we are swallowing it, it is reaching to, it is mixing up with the saliva, and it is reaching to our stomach with the help of intestine, small intestine, large intestine, and food, the pancreas. We are digesting the food, and after all, after that, we are releasing the waste from our body. These organs working together to form an organic system. The organs which helps to digest food together to form the digestive system. So different organs are connecting together to form the digestive system. The main system in our body and their functions are given in a table on the next page. So before we go to the skeleton system, we will learn about the next page, that is page number 52C. Here different columns are given, like nervous system. See, the main organs which are connected: brain, spinal cord, and nerve. Which is the function? Helps the body to gather information about the surrounding and control the rest of the body. So nervous system is making you conscious about the outer world and helping you to understand what is happening, because the brain is very important. We will read now in the next chapter. Next is skeletal system. It is made up of bone and it is giving a shape to our body. Next is muscular system. It is made up of muscles, different types of muscles which we will read. And finally, it helps the body to move. Circulatory system, heart, blood, and blood vessels. Helps the body carry food and oxygen to all part of the body, collect the waste material. So it is also acts, blood and blood vessels are there. We have to understand that these are helping us to spread the blood all over our body, and it is also helped to release the waste from our body. Next is digestive system. As we have read already, teeth, stomach, small and large intestine, and it is helping the food to be digested. Respiratory system, nose and lungs. As we know, we absorb the with the help of nose, we through the breathing tube, the air is entering our lungs, and lungs is purifying the oxygen, absorbing the oxygen and releasing out the carbon dioxide. Excretory system is kidney and skin, which helps the waste to be released from our body. And finally, reproductory system, which is different from male to female, that we will read when you will grow up. You will read different reproductive system of male and female in respect to animals and plants. And finally, helps the body to reproduce. So these are the different organ system or organic system we have in our body. And these are the different organs which are connecting together to form these functions. This you have to by heart for your objective as well as question and answer. So this is all for today. Next day we are going to start from the previous page 51, the skeletal system. Thank you very much.